Hello, Java is here. In this video, we are going to learn another integration between software, and this is integration between Revit and D5 Render. D5 Render is a great rendering software that you need to work with RTX graphic cards with it, and it is really easy to do, and the user interface is very intuitive, and you can work it very easily. To follow along with this tutorial, the thing that you need is Revit software, and don't worry, D5 Render and the we can say basic version of D5 Render is completely free, and you can use it to create really great rendering for your Revit projects, and also you can use it with other 3D softwares too. And you can follow along too. For example, you can use it for a SketchUp and other 3D programs, and that the workflow is not really different, and you can apply it to your modeling software too. As you can see on the screen here, you can download it very easily from d5render.com, and also you need to, let's go to the download part, and you need to download the Converter 2 for your 3D modeling software. Right now, the converter is available for SketchUp, 3ds Max, Rhino, ARCHICAD, Revit, and Blender. And also, you can see the features of each converter in here. For example, there are some features that are not available in some softwares. For example, direct import is not available for 3ds Max, ARCHICAD, Revit, and Blender, but it is available for SketchUp and Rhino. But after downloading both of them, and the installing process is really easy, then you need to open the project that you want to export it for your D5 render program. And the other thing is here that you can do it in both in two ways. You have export process and you have sync process, and you can have both of them at the same time too. When you install D5 Render Converter, you will have a new tab in your Revit project, and that is D5 Render. Let's go to the D5 Render. As you can see, we have the Start D5, we have Export. When you click on Export, it will give you a file. I don't want it. I'd want to create a link between this and this. For example, when I want the ability to, when I do some change in my original file, I want to be able to update it in the D5 render too. So make sure to use Start D5. But before that, let's go to the settings and let's see the things. The first one is the point of insertion. You can use between a survey point and project base point. When you don't check this on, it will apply the project base point as an insertion point in D5 render. But if you want the insertion point would be to be a survey point, you can check it. We have consistent colors, group materials by asset, and then we have an important one in here, which is export smoothness. When we have something like this, it is a cubic project. It's not really important for this. The middle is great. But when you have, for example, parametric project, for example, you have a curve or near curve surfaces, you need to put it on the higher numbers, because in the other hand, if you wouldn't do that, it will give you some broken surfaces. And then you can you have two ways. If you would select this one and select all of these in D5, you can select each of these categories separately, but the import process will take longer for this one. But if you want to just use them as a material base, as you use it in Lumion and other thing, and if you want to use Revit with Lumion also, I have another video that I will put the link in here. You can go and check that too, but for now I don't want to categorize them by category. I just want to categorize them by materials. Okay, that's great. And then the only thing you need to do is click on Start D5, and you need to wait until the finishing until the process is finished. If this video has been so helpful so far, please don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends and colleagues. It will help us a lot to create more videos and tutorials like this. Okay, after the process has finished, you can see this window. You just need to click on OK and it will launch the D5 for you. Let me, after the finishing process, I will be able to move the D5 render. Let me bring it in here. As you can see, we have the file. Let's go out of the building. First of all, let me put it on fly mode. I don't want the orbit mode, and then you can work with it like Enscape. For example, you can look around with right click. You can go forward and backward with WASD keys. And you can zoom and zoom out. Okay, that's great. Let's use some other things. For example, let's go to this room. Let me bring the display quality to high, for example, something like this. But let me put it on low, and then we can and after creating render, we have the highest amount of renders. Okay, for example, click on asset, or let me place some lamps in here. But before that, let me put it on something like 10 p.m. Let's wait a little bit. As you can see, it's dark now, and let's create a point light in here, and let's make it completely cool. And let me put it on something like 0.1 or maybe even less. Okay, that's great. Let's create a copy from it. To create a copy, hold shift and bring it in here. Okay, let me go in this way. You can hold control to click to select multiple objects, and let's create another copy from this set and another one for this. Okay, that's great. We have something like this, and let's go to the assets. For example, let's assign some material to the floor. For example, we want a floor and wood floor. And most of the assets are free, but if you want to access all of the assets, you need to purchase the pro version. And then you need to download an asset. For example, let me download this one and let me asset this one. And the only thing that I am going to show you other than this is to update your model in D5 render. For example, let me see, do I have any pre-downloaded wood floor here or not? I think I don't. So let's go back to here and let's assign this one to this. Now the asset has been downloaded. Let's drag it and bring it here and click on it, and it will apply to the floor that we want. And let me make these lights a little bit lighter to something like 0.5 to see the floor. As you can see, we have the floor, but the dimension is really small. Select this one, and in the stretch part, let it put like 0.5. It is still too small. Let me put it on 0.2. That's great for me. And then in the asset part, you have some models too. You just need to change it to model, and you can use all of the models in here, most of them, not all of them. Let's go to the furniture and let's bring a sofa in. I have this sofa. Let me load it into my project. We need to wait a little bit. We have it here. Okay, let me place it in here and let's rotate it a little bit, something like this. And let me bring it to closer to wall and a little bit something like this. Okay, that's great. Let me put it on the day part, day mode or something like that. for example, something like 4 p.m. Let me put my display on high quality, and then you go to the rendering and you can create a render. But this video is not about the D5 rendering tutorial. If you want to, if you want me to create some more rendering about D5, please comment down below. And let me show you another thing. Let's go out of this building and let's see this. Let's go back to the Revit and let's delete this one. Okay, that's great. And to update our model, you need to click on sync model, and then you need to wait a little bit and all of the changes will be done in the... Okay, we can do that when we are in rendering mode. Let's go to the D5 and click on this to go out from the exit from rendering mode and click on sync model again, and your model is synced. Let's go back to the D5. It will take a little bit. As you can see, our roof is now deleted, and you can use this function and this rendering tool very easily for your project. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it was, please don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends and colleagues. It will help us a lot to create more tutorials too. Okay, if you want to learn more Revit tips, you can go to this playlist that I will put this in here, and you can watch more Revit tips. I will see you on the next session.